at your very young age, you have been very successful in your singing career. From Showtime's Mini Me to The Voice Kids, and now the musical theater Les Miserables. Now, is there any advice that you can give to all the kids who aspire to be a big star like you?
Okay po. Katulad po ng sinabi ko po kanina, huwag po kayong mahiya. Always be confident. Never give up on your dreams. And have fun always. Dapat po yung ginagawa niyo po is sa puso niyo po. And it's your time to shine. Thank you po.
And you're shining like the brightest star ever, Ensan. Thank you very much. We have another question from this lovely lady over here. Please state your name.
Hi, I'm Johnny Jola from Patient Security. This is for Sir Ahako. Sir, I know a lot of parents who have talented kids like them, but they're afraid to join, to let them kids join because of the balance between school and having a career like them. What can you advise these parents? Can the kids be able to balance the school and their future career?
Yes. For me, don't let school limit the talents that you can draw out from your children. I mean, for me, parang, what, okay, ako, ito lang, kasi for us, parang naging, naka-implant na sa atin that you need to finish in 4 years, in 5 years. But for me, school naman will always be there. So, again, it will also depend on what you value more. If you want your kid to finish earlier, then you have to set the talent muna, the practices, the time spent a little aside, no? But if you want the balance of that, you know, pwede ta, pwede talaga. Thank you.
Thank you very much. Next question, please.
Good afternoon. I'm Leif Dava from Manila, Philippines. For Miss Wendy, being a beauty queen, can you share to us your determination to pursue your dreams despite adversities?
Okay, like this little girl, she didn't win the first time she joined, right? So the first time I joined the pageant, which is Bilibili Pilipinas, I did also win. And there's a lot of criticisms, there's a lot of, you know, you get sad when you lose. And if you really just want something, you will reach for it and you'll do everything to get it. Especially when your parents are there to guide you, when you have a... you know, people around you are very positive and help you reach your dream, to rehearse, to train, and the positive atmosphere. Whatever adversity it is, whatever they throw to you, eventually you'll get it if you're just really positive about it. So, like this little girl, she's very positive. Even if she said, I lost the first time, she's smiling because she knows it's a lesson for her to do something better in the next time she joined. And now look at her, she's very talented and she's here now.
Thank you very much. It's nice to see that shared history between you and Esan and your shared positive outlook on life now. Yes, next question, sir.
My question goes to Sam Concepcion. Sam, what has changed after you won Little Big Star?
I hit puberty after Little Big Star, so that pretty much changed. But I think what I love about being here is that I think I'd like to think that dreams do come true at that age, you know, and it came true for me when I was very young. And I think what I want to impart to these kids, more than the competition and more than coming out on top, is really falling in love with the craft, because it's the one thing that kept me going since I was a kid, because I actually really love this and I want to get better. And I want to see kids fall in love with singing, fall in love with acting, fall in love with dancing, the way I did. You know, if it's really for them, it's passion that's really going to carry them through. So it's really guiding these kids to enjoy it and find their passion and their love for it at a young age. Because it does happen. It happened for me.
Very inspiring. Thank you very much, Sam.
Good afternoon. I'm Josh Castro from PT before. My question is directed to Mr. Mickey Perez. How do you plan to share your knowledge in dancing?
Well, one of the things that I try to do when I work with kids is parang ginagawa ko siya palang playground, right? So first have fun. But then at the end of the day, what you would see after each performance, what I learned is, since I joined, or since I moved to the Philippines, is every time if you perform, you would always see something that you could improve. Or every time, you could attack it a bit differently. And I think with the kids, it's the same thing. I think with the kids, they will rehearse certain parts, but then there's always a way to make it different. And maybe that thing, to change their mindset that you could do something different, would even help them even more to grow or to find a different way na baka yun yung time to shine niya.
Thank you very much, Mickey.
I'm Benny Bernard from FieldStar.com. Just like to ask, what is your tip for the kids on how to get to strike a balance between showbiz and studies? Would you recommend entering showbiz at a very young age? Thank you.
That's a very hard question because I myself balance showbiz and my education. So I entered showbiz when I was already in college. But if the kid really wants to do this because she has the heart for it, no matter what age, I think the best to talk to is the parents and teach their children, talk to them what they really want. And if they really want to do this, I think you have to give it to them. Because, if you really want to do something, you can always balance everything. After school, if she wants to go and train, bring her. If she's tired, don't bring her. It's always the kid's discretion. If she's tired, huwag niyong pipilitin. Kasi pag napipilitin yung bata kung ayaw naman talaga, walang mangyayari. So always ask your children. Children will learn from their parents. Parents will learn from their children as well.
Thank you very much. Next question.